Pasifika, we hope you've had a great Christmas. This week, we are bringing you today's show from North Shore Pasifika Festival.
That's right, we're in the North Shore. It's a special show where we'll be looking back at what's happened in 2010. All the highlights, the newsmakers, and all the events.
Yes, 2010 was a difficult year for many. Just last month, New Zealand mourned the loss of the 29 men in the Pike River coal mine.
That's right, but it's also been a year of rebuilding, where Christchurch was hit by a major earthquake in early September. Many of our people were affected.
The suburb of Avonside was one of the worst hit by the quake. We arrived as Samitoa Lesatele's family was waiting to find out if she would lose her home of more than 70 years.
I don't know what to do because the only thing we can do, just move away. Because we want to look at the situation of the house.
Well, first and foremost, just keep mum and them safe at home and make sure the supplies up with food, and then just hopefully in the next hour or so we'll know what's happening with this place.
The minister of one of Christchurch's largest and oldest Pacific congregations was thankful he already had his sticker. The church sits just outside the cordoned off areas in the central city. The heritage building was gutted by fire a year ago, and renovations were due to begin last week.
We hope that the restoration project will continue on with the addition of the damage that was done by the earthquake. But at the moment, we still haven't sort of planned anything because the whole community is involved. And you can't ask for your neighbours because the neighbours are still going through the same thing as us.
While Christchurch begins the long path to restoration, Samoa has continued to rebuild since the 2009 tsunami. In July, Tagata Pasifika revisited Samoa's south coast.
Tuatanga Lord Joe Annandale's been busy over the last 9 months.
That's where our old spa was, just there.
Rebuilding his life, business and village, brick by brick.
What I had to do with Sinalei and at the village has helped distract me from the traumas of a tsunami. But all in all, I think I've recovered.
He thinks less and less about the morning that left his life in tatters, his darling wife Tui and their business snatched from him within seconds.
I'm back in my home now. We built my house at Potasi that was damaged in the tsunami. So I'm facing the realities of, you know, of being alone and, but God's good. He's taking care of me.
But up in the hills, the village of Saliapanga has relocated. 9 months on, people are still waiting for running water. Pipes have been laid around the village, but when Tagata Pasifika visited, we're told it'll be another month before water will actually start running to houses. And to make things worse, while most affected by the tsunami received 18,000 tala worth of materials to rebuild their homes, Naomi's been told she'll only get 10,000.
I don't know why other people receive 18,000 and other people receive 10,000. I don't know why they, and I think it's not fair.
Tagata Pasifika paid a visit to Samoa's Prime Minister to get some answers around the recovery process, but he refused.
You don't seem to put your mind off the tsunami. It's no longer a newsworthy issue.
But gave excuses.
There's a law called, in economics, law of diminishing returns. You talk too much about the issue, its importance is finished.
For those who've kept a watchful eye on the government and the way it's managed the rebuild of Upolu South Coast, the answer to just where the aid money has gone is still unclear.
Obviously, there are still some questions about where the aid money is spent, especially from the government side.
Back in Saliapanga, people are just getting on with life. 9 months ago, this was a tent town. Now a village is taking shape and starting to feel like home.
It's a good sign that decent homes have been built and, you know, it's good for the people.
Their old village down by the water now resembles a ghost town, as do many others along the coastline. In Laromanu, where the village was all but wiped out and where so many lives were lost, the idyllic beach is back, and so are the tourists.
In November, three Tokkelau teenagers were found after over 50 days at sea.
When did you guys realise that you were lost?
When we were like 2 weeks on the sea.
They were found almost 1,500 kilometres from their home island after around 2 months at sea. They left Atahu to visit the neighbouring Nukunonu island to get more alcohol.
They were drunk. they were drinking.
Yes.
And I was hanging out with other kids. And then they came.
We went to look for some more.
But they ran out of petrol and the boys began to drift. An aerial search was mounted in vain.
I was waving to it and these guys were sitting down.
All they had on board was a few supplies.
Coconuts,
Bottle of vodka.
But the boys survived by drinking rainwater they collected, ate fish that jumped in their boat and a bird, and they prayed every day for their rescue.
Strong boy.
When they were found, besides strong seeing boy. Their family, all they could think about was a good feed.
Coconut crab.
Water.
From tough boys to gorgeous girls, Pacific beauty pageants were still popular in 2010.
The night kicked off with bright lights on the seven hopeful contestants as they performed a Seva Samoa alongside the reigning Miss Samoa New Zealand, Christina Fa'afili. The girls then strutted their stuff for the traditional wear section, all designs showing off organic materials, some mixing tradition with foreign and contemporary influence. Next up, the sarong wear section, guaranteed to pump up the temperature and a few heartbeats.
Miss Samoa New Zealand 2010 is Marie Angelica Rice.
Six stunning girls compete throughout not one, not two, but three nights of intense competition, all fighting for the glory and the crown of Miss Tonga New Zealand.
Malalele, I'm here at the opening night where the contestants will be competing in the first two categories, which is the traditional Tongan attire and sarong wear. Oh yeah, where? It's getting hot in here, or is it just me? It's just me, isn't it?
For many of these lovely ladies, this pageant is about getting closer to their Tongan roots.
Our Miss Tongan New Zealand for 2010. It goes to Kafo Atu, Tule Mai Au.
The kingdom's just found an extra princess.
You could have been up there with those beauty pageants. Yeah, true. You're right. Well, stay with us at Tagata Pasifika as we take you back to the Pacific's 2010.